Hey guys, welcome to Cook with Nancy. Today I'm going to show you guys how to make this paneer makhani biryani. Very easy, very delicious, and super quick to make. Now, before I go ahead and start, if you're new to my channel, welcome. Please don't forget to hit the subscribe button right now. That way you don't miss on upcoming videos. Let's get started with this paneer makhani biryani. To start off, first we are going to start preparing the sauce. In a pan, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon butter and 1 teaspoon oil. The reason we are adding oil so the butter doesn't burn. Once the butter melts and the oil is nice and hot, we are going to add 1/2 teaspoon cumin seeds to splutter and saute this for a couple seconds. Once it releases nice aroma, I'm going to add 1 medium onion, roughly chopped, and saute this until it's nice and soft. It doesn't have to be browned. So once it's nice and soft, I'm going to add 3 garlic and 1 inch of ginger, just roughly chopped ginger. Go ahead and add it. 5 medium tomatoes and roughly chopped again, 3 dry red chilies, 10 to 12 whole cashews, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric, 1/4 teaspoon garam masala, 1/2 teaspoon cardamom powder, salt as needed, 1 teaspoon red chili powder. Go ahead and saute them until it's all well combined and masala is nicely combined. I'm going to add 1/2 cup of water to this and mix well and cover and cook until the tomatoes is nice and soft. Now I'm cooking this on medium high heat. And once you see the tomatoes are nice and soft, go ahead and turn off the heat and let it cool down completely and make into a smooth, fine paste. Meanwhile, here I have 2 bay leaves in a 5 cup of water, 1 mace of or jawitri, 2 cardamom pods, 2 cloves and 1 black cardamom, 1 star anise, 1 inch cinnamon stick, peel off 1 lime or a lemon, you can just add that or you can skip it, salt as needed, 2 tablespoon mint leaf, 2 tablespoon coriander leaves, and we are going to bring it to a nice boil. And now here I have 2 cups of soaked rice. I'm using basmati rice. You can use regular rice as well. Go ahead and add the rice and cook this for until it's 90% done. And once it is cooked 90%, we are going to drain the water and set it aside. Meanwhile, we will prepare the masala. Now here is the paste that the tomato paste. To this I've added 1 tablespoon kasuri methi, 1/3 of a cup fried onions. Here I have 2 tablespoon cream and 2 tablespoon yogurt. I mix them together and I'm going to add that. 2 tablespoon cilantro finely chopped, 2 tablespoon mint leaves finely chopped, 1/4 cup of green capsicum roughly chopped or diced, 1 cup of paneer nicely cubed. Now I'm going to add this and combine all well together until the paneer is nicely coated and the vegetable is nicely coated. Check for seasoning, and once it is nicely done, here I have a pan that where we are going to do the dum biryani. I'm going to add 1/2 of the paneer mixture and then 1/2 of the rice, and again 1/2 of the paneer and then 1/2 of the rice. Just repeat this process. Once you finish, on top I'm going to add fried onions, some cilantro, mint leaves. And I'm also going to add 1 tablespoon ghee around and cook this on dum for 25 minutes, nicely covered without any air releases on the side. And once it is done, you can remove this. And now we are going to give this nice flavor for the makhani biryani. So for that, what I have done, I have a lemon or a lime that I actually used it for the cooking rice. Actually putting the lemon, you can actually use a small container, and I put the hot charcoal and some ghee and let it rest for 15 minutes until it infuses nice flavor into it. And once this is done, you can just garnish with some cilantro and mint leaves and serve this nice and hot with some raita. It's so simple. I hope you enjoy watching this video. If you have any questions, let me know. I will see you soon in my next video. Till then, take care guys. Bye.